on the Memphis Grizzlies.
At State Farm, we're there for your what-ifs.
At their wedding, we'd give them a Texas toast. Sonic $3.99 grilled cheese double burger and tots deal.
SeatGeek presents The Really Into It. The confidence of knowing your concert tickets are legit brings everything to life. Yeah, SeatGeek handles the tickets, so...
It's gonna be big.
And you just got to be my date. Ow!
My queen.
Disney Pixar's Elemental. Rated PG. Only in theaters June 16th.
Do you or a loved one have type 2 diabetes? What if I told you the patch I'm wearing could reverse the onset of early diabetic kidney disease? 1B1 Immune Boost Patch each morning gives you a full day's dose of pure vitamin B delivered safely through the skin. No side effects and no harmful interaction with any medications you may be taking. New research indicates that kidney disease or diabetic neuropathy can be reversed, even prevented, by having enough vitamin B1 supplied to your body. One patch each morning delivers B1 throughout your system all day.
Studies show that high blood sugar and insulin levels improve after taking vitamin B1. Which would be important for diabetics.
And right now, Buy B1 will add a second box half off with this exclusive TV offer. Keep your diabetic vascular and neuropathy issues minimized with the B1 Immune Boost Patch. Call or go online and get your second box of B1 Immune Boost Patches half off now.
Call 800-620-6077 or order online at buyb1.com.
Front court, corner right, Martin sizing it up, hits a three. He maybe has been Miami's best player.
Caleb Martin often thinks back to the summer of 2021, when he was without a job after being waived by the Charlotte Hornets, the team that signed him when he went undrafted in 2019. Desperate to help, rapper J. Cole, a longtime friend, contacted Miami Heat assistant coach Caron Butler.
They had already had some spots filled, so I just wanted to make sure I left the gym with making them feel like, you know, they couldn't leave me walking out the door without being on the rosters.
Martin did that, making the Heat squad after the tryout. His story is one of several similar accounts of undrafted players on this Heat roster.
The undrafted group we have, a lot of us come from a similar kind of background in terms of the way we came up. And our grind and adversities we've seen.
Undrafted players like Martin and Vincent have been among the Heat's not-so-quiet heroes this postseason.
Three to shoot, Martin fires, and another three! He is stealing the Celtics' souls here tonight!
Typically, in the city of Miami, it's all about the U. For the Heat, it's all about undrafted U.
You know, we don't typically have a ton of draft picks. That's just us. It's not right or wrong. That's just our philosophy. And so we have to stockpile and develop our talent base, sometimes in different ways, to fill out a roster.
Just because you're undrafted doesn't mean you're a bad basketball player. We're talented, and we come in here and we work and we grind. And when somebody believes in you, it's hard not to believe in yourself.
Seven undrafted players have played this postseason for Miami, the most of any NBA Finals team in the modern draft era, which began in 1966.
Denver ball. They got two timeouts. They're down three. They're not going to use the timeout. Here's Murray at the top. Butler defending with four. Murray stepped back for the tie at three. No good. Rebound Miami. They need to win it. 111 to 108. Miami with the win. And the series is tied at one.
Came down to the wire, but that's how it sounded on ESPN Radio. The Heat steal game two on the road. tie up the finals at one game apiece, 111-108. Gabe Vincent led with 23 points. Jimmy Butler and Bam each had 21 and 9. Butler, 9 assists. Bam, 9 rebounds. Jokic with 41 points, but only 4 assists. Series tied at one game apiece. After scoring runs in the 7th and 8th innings on soft contact ground balls, the Yankees got a 2-run home run in the 9th from their rookie shortstop, Anthony Volpe. They beat the Dodgers 4-1. Take 2 of the 3 games in the weekend series between these two powerhouse and storied franchises. Rose Zhang lived up to all the hype, at least in her first week as a pro. The 2-time NCAA champion became the first player in 72 years to win on the LPGA Tour in her pro debut, capturing Mizuho America's Open with a par on the 2nd playoff hole against Jennifer Kupcho on Sunday. SportsCenter is presented by Progressive Insurance. Progressive protects your home, auto, boat, motorcycle, and RV, and could save you money. Visit Progressive.com.
Murray stepped back for the tie of 3. No good! Rebound, Miami! They need it, won it. 111-108. Miami with the win, and the series is tied at 1.
I mean, this is the NBA Finals, and we're talking about effort. That's a huge concern of mine.
We're giving them open shots, you know, giving them back doors or pocket passes. You know, we just weren't as disciplined as we need to be at this stage of the season, so we just got to be better all around, I think, for 4 quarters, not just that last quarter.
Keyshawn J. Willimax, ESPN Radio, presented by Progressive Insurance. Before we get into should Jay apologize to Heat fans for predicting a sweep, disrespectful cares. Brian in North Carolina has something to say to you, I think, Key. Go ahead, Brian.
Guys, I love you. Key, I love you. And listen, it's not apples to apples, but I'm not going to listen to some Mike Jackson hits while watching some Mike Jordan highlights. So if he wants to be called Michael, you got to call him Michael.
Oh, what about that?
It.
What about that,
I respect
Key?
It, Brian.
Wait, say it.
He's not going to listen to some Mike Jackson hits while watching Mike Jordan highlights and then watch a Michael Tyson fight. It's Michael Jackson and Michael Jordan and Mike Tyson.
But you don't say Michael Jordan. You say MJ.
I say Michael.
You say Michael.
I say Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan.
I know.
Well, you know him. For people that don't know him, you call him Michael.
If you were to, but you wouldn't call him Mike Jordan is the point. You call him Michael.
No, you call him MJ. If you know an MJ, it's MJ.
But when people refer to him, they say Michael Jordan.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I'm on your side.
Michael Jordan, but then if I'm having a conversation with somebody, I would say Michael Jordan. Right. I wouldn't say Mike Jordan.
And you wouldn't say Michael Tyson. You'd say Mike Tyson because those individuals clearly decided that that's how they wanted to be referred to.
So you should call him Michael Malone.
Right.
I don't want to spend 20 minutes on this.
Too
just
late now.
Call him by his name. Just call him by his name.
I don't know why you think that. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know why Key thinks that. Yeah.
I'm making it sound like Jay and I are arguing even when we're...
Yeah, we're on the same team here, Max.
Stacy in Florida. We'll see about that. Stacy in Florida. You're on KJM.
Who's Stacy?
Good morning, guys.
Morning,
Jay.
Hey,
Will,
Stacey, where are you? I told you we was gonna win.
Yeah.
Hey, listen up. Before the Denver Nuggets went on that run at the end, what did we do? We took them Nuggets away from them boys. Yes, we did. Listen, Stacy,
real quick.
Yes.
How's your dog doing? She's talking, taking Nuggets away from him. How's your dog doing?
Yeah,
you doing okay?
Yeah, I'm comforting him to be comforting those Denver Nuggets. Because, listen up, Coach. Coach Malone, he's getting on his guys, but I'm disappointed in him because if you look at this series, Coach Spo is coaching the game. He makes in-game adjustments. Coach Malone is just going on, you know, the ability of his players. He's going on that he thinks, you know, that his team is more talented. But I don't see much
coaching. A little disrespectful toward Michael Malone, a little bit.
Yeah. He's not coaching. Coach Spo is coaching.
Jay, is Michael Malone coaching or not?
Well, I mean, so he's been talking about this for a while now, Stacy, and that's part of the problem. He's been talking about certain players not feeling like they're buying in. And it does get to a certain point as a professional coach. It doesn't really matter what you say. Either some guys want to buy in or they don't. You know? Make sense, Stacey?
And he, What did he do? Was he scared at the end of the game to call a timeout? Was he scared that, oh, if I make a plan, Coach Spo has the ability to out, you know, to call a better defensive play?
Yeah, so I'm just going to push back. If you call a timeout down the stretch, I have no idea what set you're getting into defensively. And Espo is one of the best coaches in the game. So it doesn't matter what offensive set I draw. It could be the wrong set. So there is an advantage to having your more mature, experienced player in Jamal Murray, you know, actually make that read. I'm okay with the read, actually. I'm okay with the read. I mean,
but that's my point. That's my point. He knows Coach Spo is the better coach. So he has to go on the ability of his players. He can't, like, Coach Spo is different. I mean, Miami's going to win the series, like I said. We're going to win it. And I don't, as a fan, I must say, I don't care about the undrafted comments that everybody makes, because to me, that comment just means that my guys have more heart.
Yes.
And they had Stacey had a harder task today.
Yes, he's very happy today.
I'm there.
Cutting Stacey
because
off.
We have things to get to, and we can let Stacey talk all day.
Max, Stacey, I feel like you have a beef with Stacey.
No, yeah. No beef with Stacey.
Because
the producers will let her go all segment.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is.
It's not every time Stacey comes on the show, you always cut her short.
Yes, by the way, hold on. By the way, you as the host have the ability to.
I don't have the board in front of me.
But you can.
If I did, I'd be tuning you out right now.
You could tell us when to move on from Stacey.
Okay. I think, you know,
we've moved on. About 11 minutes, it's time to go.
I just want you to know, Richard Jefferson, the homie, texted me and said, be like Mike.
This is what I was trying to get to. I was trying to interrupt because RJ, he's right. He brings up Richard Jefferson.
Richard to you, not RJ.
Richard Jefferson, he'll tell me that, not you.
Hey, Jay.
JW.
Text him back and tell him Key said be quiet before he put him in the light skin club.
Man, tell Richard call in. How about that?
Hold on. Key, he's actually sort of supporting your point of view. What are you getting hostile? He's saying, as we're making the point, it's Michael Jordan.
I was trying to cut into Stacey because I wanted to announce this text that
Richard Jefferson just sent us.
I have a follow-up question. Keith, what is the light skin club?
Don't you got something to do, Max?
Richard Jefferson brings up a good point. As we're saying, it's Michael Jordan. There was an entire ad campaign called Be Like Mike.
Well, yeah, Be Like Mike, MJ, Mike.
Excuse
Jordan.
Me, let me rephrase. Rich Jefferson brings up a good point.
Richard.
Rich, well, if it's Be Like Mike, I never heard anyone call him Mike, but the campaign was Be Like Mike.
He better Dick Jefferson. Leave me, hey.
Dick Jefferson?
Why doesn't
it? Yeah, Dick Jefferson brings up a good point.
I mean.
What? That's not...
I don't.
The point it worked. Richard, it worked for the ad campaign. On the other hand, not since college did anyone refer to him as Mike Jordan in the media, right?
Yeah. Speaking of great, Prince in Colorado. You're still with us.
What's happening, fellas?
What's up?
Hey, man. All season I've been watching the Nuggets, and they've been having these type of games.
They
have a game where it's like, I can't get right. It's like, I can't get right type of game. And basically what they're going to do is they're going to come back out and they're going to run the table.
Yo, Prince, tell me something. Prince,
because we have barbecues out here. Okay. We don't have a barbecue and we're going to watch that Errol Spence and Crawford fight. I'm telling you, that's just what we do.
Prince, I have a question for you. Does Michael Porter Jr. bother you as much as he bothers me? Because you're a Nuggets fan.
Man, I've seen him all year long. He's going through some stuff. He's a young cat. He's 24.
Yep.
AG's 26. Maul's 25. You know, Yoke's only 27, but he's going through some personal stuff, man. And, you know, that's been messing with him. But when we have these can't get right games, he has real bad can't get right games. If you watch the previous game, he didn't really score very well, but man, he was getting rebounds. He had a double double. He looked okay. He was playing defense, and y'all need to stop with Yoke. Yoke don't be blocking the shots, but he plays defense. You know, he gets steals. He kicks the ball. He stops transition defense.
He DC comes on the show, you always cut her short.
Yes, by the way, hold on. By the way, you as the host have the ability to...
I don't have the board in front of me.
But you can,
if I did, I'd be tweeting you out right now.
You could tell us when to move on from Stacey.
Okay. I think, you know, we've moved on. About 11 minutes, it's time to go.
I just want you to know, Richard Jefferson, the homie, texted me and said, be like Mike.
This is what I was trying to get to. I was trying to interrupt because RJ... He's right. He brings up what Richard Jefferson.
Is Richard to you, not RJ.
Richard Jefferson. I don't tell. He'll tell me that, not you.
Hey,
JW.
Text him back and tell him Key said be quiet before he put him in the light skin club.
Man, tell Richard call in. How about that?
Hold on, Key. He's actually sort of supporting your point of view. What are you getting hostile? He's saying as we're making the point, it's Michael Jordan.
There was an entire because you keep talking over Jason. I didn't really hear.
I was trying to cut into Stacey because I wanted to announce this text Richard Jefferson just sent us.
I have a follow-up question, Keith. What is the light skin club?
Don't you got something to do, Max?
Richard Jefferson brings up a good point. That as we're saying, it's Michael Jordan. There was an entire ad campaign called Be Like Mike.
Well, yeah, Be Like Mike, MJ.
Let me rephrase. Rich Jefferson brings up a good point.
Richard.
Rich, well, if it's Be Like Mike, I never heard anyone call him Mike, but the campaign was Be Like Mike.
He better Dick Jefferson.
Dick Jefferson?
Why is it?
Yeah, Dick Jefferson brings up a good point.
I mean,
what? That's just not.
I don't.
The point is, it worked. Richard, it worked for the ad campaign. On the other hand, not since college did anyone refer to him as Mike Jordan in the media, right?
Yeah. Speaking of great, Prince! In Colorado. You're still with us.
What's happening, fellas?
What's up?
Hey, man. All season I've been watching the Nuggets, and they've been having these type of games.
Tell them, Pete.
They have a game where it's like, I can't get right. It's like, I can't get right type of game. And basically what they're going to do is they're going to come back out, and they're going to run the table.
Yo, Prince, tell me something. Prince,
we have barbecues out here. Okay. We don't have a barbecue, and we're going to watch that Errol Spence and Crawford fight. I'm telling you, that's just what we do.
Prince, I have a question for you. Does Michael Porter Jr. bother you as much as he bothers me? Because you're a Nuggets fan.
Man, I've seen him all year long. He's going through some stuff. He's a young cat. He's 24.
Yep.
AG's 26. Maul's 25. You know, Yoke's only 27, but he's going through some personal stuff, man. And, you know, that's been messing with him. But when we have these can't get right games, he has real bad can't get right games. If you watch the previous game, he didn't really score very well. But, man, he was getting rebounds. He had a double-double. He looked okay. He was playing defense. And y'all need to stop with Yoke. Yoke don't be blocking shots, but he plays defense. You know, he gets steals. He kicks the ball. He stops transition defense, man. He's a good defensive player. He's not great.
But he's not a good defensive player. Come on. He's not a good defensive player.
You can't gamble on the pick and roll, though, Prince. You can't gamble at the end on the pick and roll, though. I don't know why you do that in that situation. He's nowhere close to getting that steal, you know?
Yeah, we have these I can't get right games. They're just bad games, man. That's what Malone's talking about. He's like, what are y'all doing? It's like every 6 to 8 games, we have these bad games. Like,
right. Well, let's say that was one of them and you came close to winning. The bottom line is Jimmy Butler hasn't had a real Jimmy Butler game yet, too. You got to think that's coming. Is it time for Jay to say sorry to Heat fans, KJM?
The NBA playoffs.
It's the rolling Adebayo for a two-hand stuff. Adebayo set a tremendous screen and then rolled to the bucket and a chance for three.
You know, this is the finals. We gutted out one on that home court, so time to go back to the 305.
Continuing coverage of the NBA playoffs on Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max. This is Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max.
This summer, TXU Energy is back with Ultimate Summer Pass, starring 50% off energy charges all summer.
Everybody run for automatic energy savings.
Plus free energy on the hottest days.
Don't you see? Free days are now the coolest days.
It's this summer's hottest blockbuster, guaranteed to keep you cool.
The savings are coming from inside the house.
Ultimate Summer Pass. Energy savings never felt so cool. TXU Energy. Energy for everything. Tap the banner now to learn more.
The Venture X card from Capital One gives you premium travel benefits, perfect for seeing Taylor Swift the Eras Tour. Presented by Capital One. Ooh, I do love her. Earn 5x miles on flights and 10x miles on hotels through Capital One Travel.
Enjoy your stay in Suite 13.
Whoa, 13? That's Taylor's lucky number. The Venture X card from Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com for details.
The ghost pepper has a reputation. So does a ghost pepper wing that doesn't send you into tears make any sense? Does to us. That's why Popeye's ghost pepper wings are the perfect balance of flavor and fire. Popeye starts with intensely craveable flavor, adds the right amount of kick to keep things interesting, not inferno-ing, and then offers them at only $5 for 6 pieces. Because in New Orleans, we like to taste our food, not cry over it. Call us crazy.
Love that chicken from Popeye's.
Limited time at participating U.S. restaurants. Price may vary. Additional terms apply.
Come shop Memorial Day deals on LG appliances at Lowe's. Save on select major appliances, and when you buy more, you save more. Get up to an additional $1,000 off select major kitchen appliances, plus another 10% off on select LG four-piece kitchen suites. That's up to $2,776 in total savings. Lowe's knows appliances. Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 6/7. Savings vary based on purchase amount. Buy more, save more. Valid on appliances $396 or more. While supplies last, exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details.
Hello. My name is Jorge Gaviria, and I'm the founder of Macienda. We partner with farmers in Mexico to bring heirloom corn products to every kitchen. With my Spark Cash Plus card from Capital One, I earn unlimited 2% cash back on every purchase. And it has no preset spending limit, which means my purchasing power adapts to my business needs. My Spark card helps me fulfill my mission of bringing Masa to the masses. Capital One, what's in your wallet?
Terms and conditions apply. Find out more at CapitalOne.com/SparkCashPlus.
I think the Heat win the series.
In 7?
Yeah.
Butler drives the baseline right. Short jumper's good, and he's fouled. Jimmy Butler, a chance for 3. Hits the rolling Adebayo for a two-hand stuff. Adebayo set a tremendous screen and then rolled to the bucket and a chance for 3. Murray stepped back for the tie at 3. No good! Rebound Miami. They Heat have won it. Miami with the win, and the series is tied at 1.
Everybody get your...
You right now, Wednesday at 8:30 Eastern.
Big time to listen. Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, presented by Progressive Insurance. As I always say, game two is always the pivotal game in any series ever played. Because either one team is down 0-2 and overwhelmingly likely to lose, or it's not enough, and it's like a 50-50 proposition. So that was a huge win last night for Miami on the road. Is it now time to be concerned about the Nuggets? What if Miami defends home court? I mean, a long way to go, and the Nuggets could win easily either or both games. But you would favor usually the home team in a situation like this, and it's possible they could wind up back in Denver down one, you know, three games
down
to
1-3. Were you about to say down 1-3?
Well, you know, it used to, you're down 0-2, you're down 0-1. Why aren't you down 1-2? You know what I mean? Doesn't make any sense. Is it time to be concerned about the Nuggets, Jay?
I mean, look, it's one game. You split. The thing, though, is that they haven't lost a game at home in this postseason. It's a really big thing. So you kick off the series winning the first game, which Miami has won every home opener in the playoff series this year, right, on the road. And then you let your guard down defensively. And Miami is one of these teams that they never go away. And Denver is a young, immature team. We just had a caller, Prince, calling from Colorado, giving us the age of all the players. Talk about Michael Porter Jr., 24. You talk about players in New York, it's 27. Jamal Murray, you know, 25. You have a very young team that have bad habits at time. And Miami is a team that if those habits don't get tightened up, those screws don't get screwed in tight, they will find a way to win the series. They always have.
And what will that do to you, Jay?
I'm going to be fine regardless. Key, how would you say it? I'm going to be good regardless. I'm good.
Yes, sir.
Michael in yes, Alabama, or is it Mike? Is it Mike or Michael in Alabama?
Hey, I'm fine with, can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, first time calling. I don't mind being called Mike. As long as he ain't called me my full name, Mike McClain, but I don't mind they call him Mike.
Mm-hmm. All right, there you go. Some people don't care. Some people do. I know a Michael who really does not want you to call him Mike, but go ahead, Mike, in Alabama.
Yeah, I really don't care. I agree with you, Max. Game two, Jimmy Butler really hasn't had that, like, outstanding game, but he has been getting the team involved. So I would say I think they're going to steal game three. Because I really think when they get back home, Jimmy Butler's going to bring out that dog and act a donkey.
That's multiple animals.
He's going to act a donkey. And I also want to, you know, retract about what Keyshawn said about a week or two ago about the barbecue and cookout. I just left a thing we had back in my hometown called Class Day Out. From classes from all the way back from 73 to 2023. And it wasn't no big cookout. It was a big barbecue. Hmm. We do barbecues in Alabama.
Hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. Hmm. All right. So it's regional. That's okay. Akbar in Brooklyn. You're on KJM.
Good morning. Morning. First of all, I wanted to thank Keyshawn Johnson. Give me the ball, Keyshawn Johnson, who sincerely wanted to bring a championship to New York City. And even though he got his championship in Tampa Bay, his passion, I remember the day when Chester Verde hurt himself. He cried because he saw that it was a chance that the New York can do something. I want to bring up the Joker. And I've heard several analysis statistically compare him to Will Chamberlain, rightfully so, points, assists, and doing certain things that Chamberlain used to do. But I also want a lot of us get stuck on the contemporary, what's happening now. And I think if people would take a look, Chamberlain with Philadelphia. And he had some great teams in Philadelphia, along with the Lakers. Bill Russell had a team that beat him, even though that he was dominant. And I think this is going to be played out in this series.
Thank you. The fact that
Denver is so dominant.
That's what
and
you
know, I think Miami is going to beat them.
I can't believe it.
Because I think they're gritty.
You cut Stacey off, but you let this guy talk for as long as he's
talking. I'm letting you cut this guy off.
No.
I'm returning the favor.
Stacey, who calls in daily.
Yeah.
You cut her off.
Well, she gets a lot of airtime, and Richard Jefferson was texting us.
And you let this guy talk.
Now you talk right over him, you have no problem being rude to that call.
Let's play a hearing listening game. What did he just say?
Michael, another Michael. Is it Mike or Mike? He's talking about a dominant player being beaten by a better team. That Jokic is Chamberlain and the Heat are the old Boston Celtics teams. Please. Did I get that right? I'm hoping that's what he said. Michael on the highway. Is it Mike or Michael?
Man, you can call me either or. It don't make me none. But I just wanted to say first, man, y'all. Get me right in the mornings, man. Been listening to y'all since the beginning. Shout out to the producers for putting Max in over Zubin. Zubin. But I just want to comment on the Nuggets series. Shout out to Keyshawn. I think every championship team, you got to have a dog. You got to have at least one guy that's not your best player that's just grimy. He got to be grimy, dirt under the fingernails. There's nobody on the Denver squad. If I was in a fight, I would call. Not one. I'm with you, Keyshawn. Too many red bones.
What are you with Keyshawn on, though? Let me ask you, what are you with Keyshawn on?
Don't worry about what he's with me on.
I'm confused.
He's with me. That's all
he's with you, but with you on what? You picked Denver to sweep them.
Don't worry about it.
You picked Denver to sweep Miami. So what is he with you?
He's with me.
Hey, too many red bones. Too many light skins. You need somebody that's going to throw some hands.
Chef
Green.
Go talk to Shane Mosley before you start with that.
Not with Elvis. That ain't what I said. I didn't have nothing to do with that, Jay.
See what you done started.
See, as soon as someone's with you,
I didn't say nothing about Denver got too many light-skinned dudes. That's Michael from New York to somewhere. I don't know.
Where was he from? He's from the highway.
Nobody said that with Golden State when they were winning back-to-back chips.
I didn't say that with Denver. We're not going to have my name on somebody's report.
He said he with you. And you said,
no,
you
said he's with me, but not with that.
Oh, now he's not with you. So which one is it? He with you or he not with you? I'm confused. Yeah.
But see, Golden State had...
No, don't qualify. Stop.
What you mean?
Stop. See,
they did have the brothers, you know, but then they also had...
I'm going to stay out of this one. Yeah, did the Heat find the remedy for this series in game two?
They also got a guy.
KJM, ESPN.
Don't pay a plumber to come out and quote your job. Just get a free estimate from Aqueduct Plumbing. We're the repiping experts here in Houston and can take care of any plumbing project, no matter how big or small, including drainage and tunnel, new construction, leak detection, water heaters, remodels, and more. And unlike some competitors, we don't subcontract the work out. Call Aqueduct Plumbing Company today at 281-488-6238. That's 281-488-6238. Aqueduct Plumbing is at your disposal.
I think I feel it. I had a teammate throw up in Denver. I was like, yo.
The fabled Mile High City altitude is no myth. Since the Nuggets entered the league in 1976, no other active franchise has won 30% more of their games at home than on the road.
Good job. Push.
From monitoring nutrition to getting out into nature, the Nuggets do all they can to acclimate to the altitude.
Go, fellas, go.
We usually go to Red Rocks, do conditioning there. So even Red Rocks is a little bit higher than downtown Denver. So you go to a higher altitude train and then come back to a lower altitude.
That strength change, condition change, it helps me a lot on the floor, you know. I don't get tired that much. I feel stronger.
Throws it down and the foul.
Nikola Jokic is a scoring machine here in the third quarter.
The Denver Avalanche.
We've faced tough times this year, and so we've learned how to handle setbacks and then just getting to work.
10 straight points by the Heat. And Miami, their first lead since early in the second quarter. Duncan Robinson drives.
Tremendous response. Miami's overcome a 15-point deficit. Back out to Murray. His three-pointer. Three-point game. 4 seconds. Murray, step back. Three-pointer. One goal. And it's over. The Miami Heat have tied the NBA Finals. What a comeback here on the road for the Heat.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, ESPN Radio. We are presented by Progressive Insurance. On this lovely day in New York City, J. Will not happy with the weather over the weekend. A little unseasonably cool, but quite nice.
Oh, Jay. Oh, boy. Look at you. What's up there, Max? Now?
What's going on, boy?
I had your hand. I cut mine off, Max.
Go on, Tom. Keep going, Tom.
You got the charcoal going, Kate?
All day.
And I really like Kirk Goldsberry, one of my favorites, ESPN NBA analyst, with us right now. Morning, Kirk.
What is up, guys? How are you, Max?
What's going on? You tell me. Like, this is what I want to know right off the bat, okay? Ooh. The Heat, it's one thing to say they're shooting unlike they shot in the regular season, or it's unsustainably high. But throughout my lifetime watching sports, I do think there are some people who can seem to maintain an unsustainably high level of performance in high leverage situations. Doesn't mean they're going to do it every time, but the performance changes. And throughout these playoffs, the way the Heat have been shooting, is this something that at this point you can say, yup, in the playoffs, they are capable of doing this some more, or do you expect regression to the mean?
Man, it's too late for regression to the mean. I think you're right. They ranked 27th in three-point percentage during the regular season, worse than my beloved Spurs, worse than the tanking Pistons.